McIntosh and Bradshaw set to bring them to green here off turn number four. They'll pull the trigger, smash a loud pedal, and here we go. Oh, we've got contact right off the get-go. Brian Connor, Craig Vosbergen. No caution lights are out. Well, looks like we are now coming to green. Eyes on them here off turn number four. They'll pull the trigger, and here we go with qualifying heat number one. Down the front straightaway into turn number one, McIntosh and Bradshaw battle for the lead. McIntosh comes out of there with it. Smith looking beneath Bradshaw for the second position down into turn at number three. You throw Grandma's quilt over him into turn three. Bradshaw slips. Smith going to slip through the gap and go into the second position. Smith challenges McIntosh for the lead. He's beside of him off two. Not able to make a move. Doe down the back straightaway. They'll set him down into turn number three. McIntosh and Smith. Smith a little out of shape. That lets McIntosh get away from him just a bit there off of turn four as they battle their way around the bull ring here at Swainsboro Raceway tonight in night number five of Schaefer's Oil Southern National Series action presented by Sunoco Race Fuels and Tennessee RV. McIntosh shows the way. G.R. Smith rides in second. Donald Bradshaw third. The 77 of Brian Connor in fourth. Pearson Williams rides in fifth. As we're about to see the halfway signal, we'll have four down, four to go right there. In super late model heat number one, and G.R. Smith getting racy with McIntosh for the lead. He'll look beneath him. They're side by side through 3 and 4 inches apart. Coming at you down Main Street here at Swainsboro Raceway. McIntosh will hang on to the top spot. Smith's been a little bit better on entry into turn three, but McIntosh has been a little better in exit off of turn number four and been able to keep Smith at bay for the time being. Yeah, so we should be seeing a white flag this time by here off of turn number four. White flag going to be displayed to race leader Donald McIntosh. One lap to go here in qualifying heat number one. McIntosh works that car down the back straightaway for the final time into turn three off of turn number four. Dawsonville, Georgia's Donald McIntosh, winner of heat one. G.R. Smith will come home in second. Donald Bradshaw going to finish in third, and the fourth and final transfer spot will go to Brian Connor. So your top four out of this one, finishing fourth, Brian Connor in 77, third to 93 of Donald Bradshaw, second to 22 of G.R. Smith. And grabbing the win in super late model heat number one in the Blunt Motorsports owned Rocket Big Hill powered old Ben Franklin stores, Cherokee Millwright Blunt Excavating, Stowers Cat Service, Cherokee Millwright Tennessee RV Super Center, sponsored number seven out of Dawsonville, Georgia. Swainsboro Raceway, give him a big round of applause. D-Mac, Donald McIntosh. Dixon and Fitzgerald looking better this time. Green's going to wave. Here we go. Into turn number one, Brent Dixon and Jason Fitzgerald battle for the top spot. Fitzgerald has it by 3/4 of a car length as they enter turn number three. They'll make their way off turn number four here at the Lightning Fast Swainsboro Raceway tonight. Yeah, we got caution. Caution is out. As the 10 of Ryan Crane's machine sets stop to the top of turn number three. Clear them out and get ready to come to green. Fitzgerald in charge of the restart single file, nose to tail. Here off of turn number four with one lap official. Here we go. Fitzgerald leads them into turn number one. Dixon's going to be second. Whitener will be third. Franklin will be fourth. Ryan Crane around David Doherty into fifth. He has a Dixon thought about taking a peek beneath Fitzgerald, but ducked back in line as they race down into turns one and two. Fitzgerald hanging on to the top spot. He and Dixon putting just a little bit of distance between himself and the third place running machine of Mark Whitener. As Dixon trying to get a run on Fitzgerald, with Fitzgerald's car hugging the bottom of the racing surface here at Swainsboro Raceway and not letting Dixon be able to jump underneath him and take a peek here. As we close in on the midpoint of this one, halfway being shown to the field, four down, four to go here in qualifying heat race number two. Fitzgerald again continues to sit on the point. Dixon rides in second. These two drivers, a lot of laps here at Swainsboro Raceway. as is Mark Whitener in third, and former two-time winner here at Swainsboro with the Southern Nationals. Dennis Rambo Franklin in that fourth and final transfer spot. Dixon awfully close to going over the center of the back straightaway, but keeps that car pointed straight, but loses a lot of valuable ground to race leader Jason Fitzgerald in the seven machine. Field racing down the back straightaway and into turn number three as they bring them off turn number four. It looks like we're going to see the white flag. One lap to go here in qualifying heat number two. Fitzgerald down the back straightaway. He'll go for the final time. And off of turn number four, Middleburg, Florida's Jason Fitzgerald will be the winner. Second will be Brent Dixon. Third will go to Mark Whitener. And fourth will go to Dennis Rambo Franklin. So that's the way they finish here in qualifying heat number two. Your top four that transfer on, finishing fourth, Dennis Franklin in the two. The other number two there, the two cool machine, Mark Whitener finishes third. Brent Dixon will finish second and take it a win in heat race number two. The Longhorn Cornette powered Southway Crane Fields Concrete Longhorn chassis sponsored entry for Middleburg, Florida native Jason Fitzgerald. Give him a big round of applause, Swainsboro Raceway. In tonight's main event, heat four, you need to be in staging ready to go. Heat three, featuring Page and Roberts, Buckingham, Collins, Lloyd, and Rogers comes to green. Here we go. Down into turns one and two. Michael Page jumps to the early race lead. Casey Roberts going to be in second. Kenny Collins third. Ivadent Lloyd working beneath Shannon Buckingham for the fourth spot and put Ivadent to fourth. Move Buckingham back to fifth. Off two down the back straightaway they go as Roberts looking beneath Page for the lead and put Casey Roberts on the point. Kenny Collins trying to slip through as well. Not going to be able to do it. Page will close the door on him. And Roberts driving away from the field here as we close in on the midpoint, but we got caution. Caution is out as Shannon Buckingham's number 50 machine stopped at the center of turns one and two with a flat left rear tire. They'll pull the trigger on him. Green's back out. Here we go. Roberts hard into turn number one. Gets a good run and out to a big advantage here over Michael Page as Ivadent Lloyd looks beneath Kenny Collins for third. And Collins, it looks like he just simply lost it and loops it in turn number four. Caution, flag is out. As we get set to come to green here off turn number four, green's back out, and here we go. Roberts will take the field off to as Lloyd jumps to the outside of Page. Down the back straightaway and into turn number three. Ivadent Lloyd, who started back in the fifth position originally, tried to get second but drifted high in turn four, and it let Michael Page reclaim that spot as Buckingham looks beneath Lloyd in two, but nothing doing there. Yes, Casey Roberts has pulled away from the field here in the early going of heat race number three. Laps winding down in it. We're past the halfway point, and it is the Casey Roberts show out in front of this one right now. Michael Page second. Ivadent Lloyd is third with Shannon Buckingham holding down that fourth spot. Lloyd. He had to jump out of the accelerator there and lost some car lengths to second place Page there as they come off turn number two. Meanwhile, Casey Roberts continues to show the way as the lap's winding down here in this one. We should be looking for the white flag this time off of turn number four. One lap to go in qualifying heat number three. Casey Roberts looking to seal the deal here now off turn number two. Down the back straightaway, he'll race for the final time. Through turns three and four, qualifying heat race number three will go to Toccoa, Georgia's Casey Roberts. Second will be the 18X of Michael Page. Third will be the 58 of Ivadent Lloyd Jr. And fourth, the 50 of Shannon Buckingham. So fourth will go to the 50 of Shannon Buckingham. Third to the 58 of Ivadent Lloyd. Second to the 18X of Michael Page. And taking the win in qualifying heat race number three in the Cushman Motorsports Longhorn Clements powered Cushman Paint and Body M&S Concrete Schaefer's Racing Oil, sponsored number 101 out of Toccoa, Georgia. Give him a big round of applause, race fans. Casey Roberts. He is. The green light's on, and we are looking to come to green right here in heat race number 4, the final one of the night. Sherry Ann Ligon set to bring him to green. Green is out, and here we go. Scott Sherry going to jump out to the early race lead. Steve Casebolt trying to go to second. He'll move Brian Ligon back to third. As those are your front three here on the opening lap. Casebolt with a power move beneath Sherry. He'll grab the race lead off turn number 4 down the main straightaway. As Ligon slips there, that's going to open the door for Carpenter to go to third possibly. But Ligon able to gather it back up. Casebolt continues to lead the way. Sherry in second. Carpenter beneath Ligon again through turns 1 and 2. And Carpenter going to have the third spot this time. Shuffle Ligon back to fourth. Yes, Casebolt continues to lead the way out in front in the C9 machine. Shirey riding in second. Casebolt the leader, Shirey in second. Carpenter third, Ligon in fourth. Then it is Skelton and Walker as we are past the halfway mark in this one. And Steve Casebolt tied for fourth in the series points coming into the ninth action, showing the way in qualifying heat number 4. Scott Shirey rides in the bridesmaid spot. Brandon Carpenter rides in the third spot. Brian Ligon in fourth as the lap's winding down here now in the fourth and final qualifying heat of the night. Crate Late Models, you should be in line, ready to go. Crate Late Models should be ready. 440s, we need 440s in staging, please. 440s to staging. White flag in the air, one lap to settle it here. In a qualifying heat, number 4. Casebolt working down the back straight away for the final time. He'll bring that machine off to number 4, Richmond, Indiana. Steve Casebolt taking the win in qualifying heat number 4. Scott Shirey will finish in second. Brandon Carpenter going to come home in the third spot with Brian Ligon finishing in position number 4. Check in. And again, Kenny Collins in the 71X. He was eligible for series provisional, couldn't get his car to go. So and the one to go signal being shown. Rays fans, we are coming to green next time by here at Swainsboro Raceway in what should be a dandy of a main event. Raleigh Hickman and Ross Bales will bring them to green here. Swainsboro Raceway, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's showtime! Green will wave and we are underway. Raleigh Hickman jumps out to the early lead. Bales trying to work back beneath him, bring Overton with him. They're side by side for the lead. Thought about making it 3 wide off of turn 4, inches apart. Hickman's going to lead them through on lap number 1. Hickman leads lap 1. Bale's going to be second. Overton and Henderson going at it for third and fourth. McIntosh is fifth. Hickman leading the way. Bale's riding in second. Overton holds down the final podium position right now in third. Henderson is fourth. And we're going to have a caution. Ivan Denton Lloyd Jr.'s machine slows up at the top of turn at number 4. As they'll bring them back to green here off of turn number 4. Hickman in charge of the restart, and here we go. Overton going to go to second here on the restart, it appears, with Bales right there. But Overton going to have the second position. Bales third, McIntosh up to fourth. And Roberts now rides in fifth. Riley Hickman showing away. Ross Bales second as Vosburgen's machine slows, and he'll make the right turn into the outside pit area. Hickman leading as Bales back around Overton. Bales trying to pressure Hickman, but nothing doing up to this point. Hickman continues to lead the way. Bales trying to charge to the inside of Hickman here off turn number four. Takes a look, not able to make the move. Overton is third, McIntosh fourth, Roberts fifth, Henderson sixth, G.R. Smith seventh, Fitzgerald is eighth. Hickman continuing to lead the way down the back straightaway. Bales trying to get a run on him as Connor will pull the 77 machine into the infield. His night looks to be finished. As the field going to start working slower traffic here in a lap or two. Hickman and Bales run 1-2. Overton sets in third. McIntosh fourth. Roberts fifth as those five have put some distance between themselves in a battle for sixth between the 2X of John Henderson, the 22 of G.R. Smith. Oh, and oh my. First and second. Hickman and Bales. I believe that's a car Kenny Collins is driving. Caution lights are out, and we are getting set to come to green here off turn number four, and here we go. Overton going to lead them through. McIntosh slips, and Roberts going to go to second. G.R. Smith through. He's got to go to third. Overton shows the way. Roberts second. Smith is third. McIntosh fourth. Fitzgerald now fifth. Is McIntosh working, trying to work back beneath Smith, but not able to do it. Case Bolt's machine slows here on the front straightaway. We'll see if he can get that car off the racing surface, and he will. He will make his way into the infield. Overton continuing to show the way here out in front of this one. Stretching that lead out here over second place running Casey Roberts. G.R. Smith third, Donald McIntosh fourth, Jason Fitzgerald fifth, John Henderson sixth, Mark Whitener seventh, Dennis Franklin eighth, Brent Dixon ninth. And Ross Bales has made his way up to 10th. Overton continues to lead the way in that 116. Has a pretty comfortable advantage right now over the second place running machine of Casey Roberts. Smith holds down the third spot, McIntosh fourth, Fitzgerald still fifth. But Overton, Wither, definitely set on keel here at this point, showing the way. No, after we interviewed him after his second place finish last night, he said he was looking forward to coming to Swainsboro and Scranton, a couple of tracks that he was very, very familiar with. And Overton showing the way right now out in front of this one. Get a 53 laps of distance here tonight for $5,300. As Overton wearing them out here at this point, with Roberts still second, Smith third, McIntosh in fourth, Fitzgerald rides in the fifth spot. And we got caution. Caution is out. Slowed over on the back straightaway. And race leader Overton coming to the attention of one of the Swainsboro Raceway officials here down in the turn four. And race leader Brandon Overton has pulled the 116 machine to the work area. Problems on the 116. Casey Roberts in charge of the restart. Here off of turn number four, eyes on them. They're going to roll a green, and here we go. McIntosh trying to roll by Smith for second, and looks like he may have that done. But Smith battling back with McIntosh side by side for the bridesmaid spot off two down the back straightaway. All this going on by our race leader, Casey Roberts. McIntosh and Smith continue to battle side by side for second. Fitzgerald is fourth. Henderson is fifth. McIntosh regains control of the second position for the time being as Casey Roberts sets sail out in front. Roberts, the winningest driver in Southern Nationals history here at Swainsboro Raceway. He's got three series victories here at Swainsboro. And right now sitting in the catchbird seat to possibly get victory number four. And Roberts has rolled off from the sixth starting position here in this one. McIntosh riding in second. G.R. Smith third. Jason Fitzgerald fourth. Yeah, the 2X of John Henderson is fifth. As the two of Dennis Rambo Franklin up between cars, he's trying to grab sixth down in turns one and two from a fellow number two driver, Mark Whitener. But Whitener going to hang on to that sixth spot for the time being as they battle off turn four down the main straightaway. Meanwhile, race leader Casey Roberts continues to lead the field off into the back straight, down the back straightaway and into turn three, has about a half straightaway lead over second place running Donald McIntosh at this point in the contest. Roberts and that Cushman paint and body, sponsored number 101, continues to lead the way. The halfway signal goes down here in this one. 27 down, 26 remain here in tonight's Schaefer Oil AMA, your Schaefer Oil top 10. Casey Roberts, the leader. Donald McIntosh, second. G.R. Smith is third. Jason Fitzgerald, fourth. Sean Henderson, fifth. Mark Whitener, sixth. Dennis Franklin, seventh. Brandon Overton has made his way back up to the eighth spot. Donald Bradshaw, ninth. Brent Dixon, tenth. And Bradshaw back around Overton. But Overton is rim riding that high side. Folks, keep an eye on that 116 battling back there. That young man has no quit in him whatsoever, and he is driving his way back toward the front, back to the ninth spot. But race leader Casey Roberts comes down and heads off into turn number one, going to start the process of working traffic right here. We complete lap 31 to race leader Casey Roberts. Going to have to start working traffic now. He'll put the 10S of Scott Cherry one lap down. Flirting with the edge of that back straightaway. As the 77 of Connor will pull his machine off once again. And we got a car slowing up in turn at number two. And it looks to be Donald Bradshaw's number 93 machine. Caution, flag is out. Unofficially 32 laps complete. As Roberts gets set to bring him to green here off of turn number four. Green's back out. Here we go. McIntosh trying to charge the outside of Roberts off turn number two. And he may have that done down into turn number three. Put McIntosh on the point for the moment. McIntosh now sets out in the front. Roberts is second. Yes, Fitzgerald, and look at there, Brandon Overton, folks, is back up to third. Keep an eye on that 116, folks. He is on the move. McIntosh leading it, Roberts second. Overton sets in third. Overton's charged his way back to third and he's got his sights set on the front two here. McIntosh and Roberts, and here comes Overton around the outside, but we got caution. Caution is out. Oh my. Caution lights are out. Pull them belts real tight once again as we're getting ready to come back to green here off turn four, and here we go. McIntosh will bring them through. McIntosh will lead them off turn number two. Up between cars, D.R. Smith, they go three wide. Down the back straightaway. Smith trying to go from fourth to third. They're still three wide off of turn number four. Oh my, and Roberts has gone to second. We got caution, caution is out as we got a car spun down in turn number four, Brent Dixon. McIntosh with the field in tow. We'll try it again here off turn number four, and here we go. Into turn one, Overton's car up off the ground momentarily. Smith thought about making the shooting a gap once again. This time not going to be as successful. As McIntosh shows the way, Roberts second, Overton third, Fitzgerald fourth. Mark Whitener now rides into fifth spot. As Smith's machine starts to fade here a little bit. At this point in the event, here comes Overton. Overton trying to get a run on Roberts for the second position. He was good on the high side earlier. It took him a couple of three laps to get going. If we stay green here, let's see what happens. As a McIntosh will come through and lead him down for another lap, Roberts is second. It looks like 38 laps scored. McIntosh comes down. Took him to complete another lap, Roberts second. And caution's going to wave. Caution is out again. Yes, G.R. Smith's machine. We knew he was fading right there a bit. Slowed on the track down in turn number one. Back to Green. Smith's going to return out the gap in turn number four. Green's going to come back at it. Here we go. Off of turn two, they go down the back straightaway. McIntosh shows the lead. Overton looking to the outside of Roberts, trying to get second. Slides up the banking in turn number four, but Roberts trying to get a run on McIntosh now for the lead down into turn number one. And Roberts to the lead. One-on-one, Roberts back to the lead. McIntosh second now. And here comes Overton around McIntosh. And we got caution. Caution is out. Jason Fitzgerald slowed on the back straightaway. Second place McIntosh has chosen the outside. He'll put Overton to the inside. As they get ready to pull back to green, Fitzgerald has returned. They'll get ready to come back to green. Here we go. Roberts will lead him off of turn number two. Three wide for third. Mark Whitener up in the mix as well. Whitener looking to go to third. He gets completely sideways. And caution's going to wave. Wow. Caution lights are out. Looks like we may be going to go single file on this restart to finish it out. Roberts brings them by. Overton looks to the inside of McIntosh. McIntosh going to try to get a run on Roberts off two down the back straightaway. Looking to the outside of Roberts for the lead here off of turn number four and put McIntosh back on the point. McIntosh retakes the lead on lap 41. Overton setting his sights on Roberts now for second. And put to 116 by on lap 43 for the second spot. And Overton gonna set his sights on McIntosh now for the race lead.
It's gonna be 44-45.
44 complete, 9 to go. And G.R. Smith's machine slows up in turn 1 and 2. They'll pull the trigger on them, come back to green here off of turn number 4. Here we go. Overton going to try to go to the bottom and grab the lead from McIntosh. Not able to get the job done at this point. D-Mac closes the door on him here off of 4. McIntosh and Overton will battle for the lead as Buckingham pressures Roberts for the third spot. Down the back straightaway and into turn number 3. McIntosh 1 and Overton was second last night. That's how they've run right now. As Buckingham has taken that third position. And we got a car over the back stretch, car over the back straightaway. And it is the 101 of Casey Roberts. So we get set to come back to green. The top three in series points run, first, second, and third right now. Dennis Franklin fourth, Brent Dixon fifth. McIntosh will lead him down the back chute one more time. Overton is second. Fitzgerald's machine slows. Going down the back straightaway into turn 3, and he's going to take that car to the outside pit area. Yes, it looks like 6 of the original 22 starters still on the racing surface with just a handful of laps remaining. McIntosh and Overton 1-2. Buckingham is third. Franklin fourth. Dixon fifth. Shirey in sixth. Yes, we got laps winding away. Just a handful remain here. Is Overton trying to seal the deal? And Overton pulls off. Overton will pull off. Overton pulled his machine off. McIntosh with it well in hand at this point. Buckingham in a second. Dennis Franklin rides in third. As we're about to get this one concluded here for you. McIntosh going down the back straightaway. White flag in the air, one lap to settle it, and it is all Donald McIntosh. He can just about coast it home from here. Down the back straightaway for the final time. He's going to score a hat trick, make it 3 in a row. Donald McIntosh wins with the Schaefer Oil Southern National Series at Swainsboro Raceway. Second is going to be Shannon Buckingham. Third will be Dennis Franklin. Brent Dixon going to be fourth, and Scott Shirey looks to be fifth. And he's out of the car race, fans. Let him know you appreciate him. 3 straight Schaefer Oil Southern National victory for the driver, the number 7, Donald McIntosh. And he leans back against the car and kind of looks up to the heavens. Young man, have you ever worked as hard in 53 laps as you did out there tonight?
I don't believe I've ever worked as hard in 24 years. Man, I can't thank Vic Hill enough. It says a lot about these motors to go through what we put them through right now. And Rocket Chassis, Stowers Cat, Massey Electric, everybody's here, man. These guys don't make it easy on us down here at this track. I know they try, but, man, it's been the same way the last couple of years. And it's rough. But, man, three in a row. I guess it's just now sinking in. I really didn't think about it. I was just wanting the race to be over. But I can't thank these guys for staying behind me enough. What a night.
When Roberts rolled past you right there with about 13 to go, the caution comes out and you think, well, am I going to have to settle for second right here? But you momentum that top side and was able to make what would turn out to be the race-winning pass there with a Baker's dozen left. Talk about the pass in one and two.
Well, being on the bottom was a smart move, but we're all out here racing, so at the top it was rough, but I knew it had some speed to it, so I went in there as hard as I thought I could, and it come out the other end. I tell you, I've never been looking for a white flag so much in my life. He said five to go, and I swear we ran 12 laps there at the end. I'm like, come on, that white flag's got to be coming. He's forgot it or something. So, but, well, what a night.
Give him a big round of applause. Donald McIntosh wins here at Swainsboro Raceway. Yeah, no, we'll slide back here. Get a few words with our runner-up finisher, Shannon Buckingham. Son, you just keep plugging away there. Attrition may have played in your favor tonight. Some of the folks in front of you fell out, but another podium finish. You were third in points coming into tonight, a couple of straight third-place finishes, and you put the Double Down Motorsports number 50 on the podium once again with a runner-up finish here tonight.
Yeah, I kind of set us behind in qualifying. I didn't make a very good lap, and then we got ran over in a heat race. I don't know what that was about. But honestly, we started so far back, we knew it was going to get rough. I just made my mind up I was going to park it on the bottom and try to survive. We're points racing. I didn't think we would get that far up. And, you know, even with five to go, Donald and Brandon, man, they are abusing their stuff up there. And I don't know how rough it looks to you guys, but it's a lot worse. Sometimes you go home after the weekend, you look at the video, and you see those cars just floating through there, and you think, well, that didn't look bad at all. But it's brutal. But hats off to those guys, man. He got up on the wheel and did what he had to do. I'm happy to be in second. We just tried to points race and bring this thing home in one piece, so we got something to go to Scriven tomorrow night.
Big round of applause to tonight's runner-up finisher, Shannon Buckingham, out of Morristown, Tennessee. And we'll slide back here and get a few words with third-place finisher Dennis Rambo Franklin out of Gaffney, South Carolina. What did you do that for? Young man, you had a catbird seat, so to speak, to see everything going on in front of you at the start of this thing because of where you started at toward the back of the field. But you done what you had to do, survived. You had to go to the infield work area a time or two there. But you'd be able to bring this Red Deuce home, the final spot on the podium in third, sir.
Well, you know, we drawed a one to go out to qualify in the racetrack with Soupy, and that just killed us, you know. And that dug us a hole. We made the show, and I told him, I said, it's going to be nutrition. You know, the racetrack was rough, and we went and lost brakes probably with about 10 to go. I believe we could have rolled that top a little faster, but I was just scared about going over the back stretch over there, so I just had to take it easy and make sure I was pointed the right way. And I don't know if it killed them when that tire went down over there. I mean, I mashed them pretty hard, and they went to the floor, and it was just I had to cruise then.
Big round of applause for tonight's third-place finisher, Dennis Franklin.